Hey, this is Mad Hatter, and I'm in a creative copy of one of my various worlds, and I am playing on a local server of it, and I want to show you something that I built that works on Twitch that is currently integrated with this server. So if I jump over to my Twitch dashboard or my Twitch channel, I can click a button like this one, confirm. I would have spent bits there if it wasn't on my test server, and now I'm up here and I will have to jump to survive and place the slime block if I'm, you know, without an elytra. And now that is a base jump, and we could continue playing if we were, you know, like in a stream playing. So anyway, this is a called Bedrock Spawns. It's a Bedrock extension and a Twitch extension that work together to allow you to have viewer interaction while you're streaming. If you like it, subscribe and follow. Watch the rest of the video to show how to set it up. And by the time I publish this video, it should be out and available. So thanks everybody, and we'll get into it. So the first thing I'm going to do is install the extension. So right now I have this version, which is in a test version, and it needs to be attached to a panel. You can choose whichever panel that you want. I'm going to set this to panel 3, and I'm going to replace this simple emotes one. So now that I have Bedrock Spawns as a panel, we can start to configure. On here, this is what you should see when you get started. We have a number of windows. We have the server settings. We have simple commands. We have custom commands. We have the command manager. And we have view submitted and credits. So the first thing that we're going to want to do is get our BDS instance set up. This video is going to cover how to set up things in Bedrock Dedicated Server. There is also a way that you can do this for single player games, but that's not going to cover in this video. It'll just get covered in the text. So we're going to click here. If we are making our own server, we will host a server. If somebody else has a server, we can join their server. So we'll get to how to do that in a second. So to create a server, we hit this create server button, and we give the server a name. So Hatter's test server is a good start. And I do this get token. Now this token is actually the password and the name of the server and all of that information that we need for our BDS instance to connect. So you're going to copy this out. You can hit the copy button and it helps you. If that doesn't work in your web browser, which some web browsers don't support copy, you can just highlight and copy all of it. In your Bedrock dedicated folder, you should have a config. If you go into default, you're probably going to need to make a variable.json file. That's just a text file named variables.json. If I go and I edit this file, which popped up on a different screen, I have an old test server that I've deleted, and we're going to go and paste that string in. It doesn't have to be formatted, but if you want to see what it looks like, we can use one of the JSON formatters to take a look. What this is the server name, the key, which hopefully I have blurred out, and the name of the server. And then this number is the owner's Twitch account number. Now I'm going to hit save. The next thing that we're going to have to do is we're going to go into behavior packs, and we're going to extract the Bedrock Spawns behavior pack, which you can find a link for in the description, into here. This should all be set up already. You just need to drop it into the behavior packs folder. And then in the worlds folder, you need to select the world that you want this to be active on. I'm going to show you on Flat World. That's just one that I was playing with. We're going to go and we're going to look at the world behavior packs. If that doesn't exist, you need to make a JSON file again that just says world underscore behavior packs underscore JSON. And then you're going to copy this string, which is in the description, into your behavior packs JSON file and save it. At this point, our server is set up and we can get on to doing other things, the other more interesting things. So what we needed to do was change the config, add a default config for the server using the setup token. We needed to change the behavior packs and add in our behavior pack and then attach the behavior pack to the world that we want to run. Now, if I go into configure settings, you'll see I now have a dropdown and you can change this to however many servers that you want. And the one that you have selected is active for your account. Now, what I mean by that is if you have 10 servers that you want, they'll all work for anybody who has joined them. But when you want to be working on that world, you need to select your hosted server. So if you have friends that you wanted to host servers for or whatever, that is how you select between your hosted servers. The next thing that we want to change is we want to put in your Minecraft name. So for me, that's Raven Mad Hatter, and this needs to be exactly what you would run in the commands. So when you run a command, you do, you know, TP and then your whole name, Raven Mad Hatter or whichever your name is, and then you would run a command. This is going to allow the Bedrock spawns to target you when you want to. So now we're going to hit publish. Publish saves our changes to the cloud and it allows this thing to work. So now we have all of these items set up. If you want to add a friend to your server, you can do new player token. This token is good for 24 hours. After 24 hours, they can't join. So be wary of that. You get a new token, you copy it. And then we're going to just set it up as a join on our own server. You do not have to join your own servers. You're automatically joined. But if I go to join server, I can paste in that token that we had got and click join server. Give it a little bit. And you see I have the same dropdowns. Normally, you would not need to join your own servers. But like I said, this is just to show you how it works. If you hit leave server, it tears down that server connection and you no longer have permissions on it and you'll have to ask for another token. And if you hit delete server, it deletes all of the permissions for that server so it no longer can be used. So that is how we do server setup and joining of servers. I hope it's easy enough for you to understand. I think it's nice and clean, and let me know what you think in the comments if there's something that's confusing. So now that we've set up a server, we're going to start adding some simple commands. Simple commands, you can actually, if you have affiliate status, you can actually charge bits for. And if we want to set up a command, we give it a name. This name is what's going to display on our Twitch panel at the bottom when viewers are watching and playing. So like, if you have something like it, we're gonna page through here. If you have like give XP and it's gonna be level me up, the person who is watching your stream will see level me up, and then you can select how many bits that would be. So like if that's 20 bits to give you 1,000 XP, that's all you would need to do. I hit publish, and now if I go to return and I go to the command manager, you'll see that level me up is inside of the command manager. Now I can delete these things out of the command manager. And then I can hit return. And if I go to my Twitch channel, I'm just going to refresh to make sure that I get the current one. You'll see that we have level me up for 20 bits. Now, if I want to add another command, I can go through here and select. You notice that there's a lot of commands in here, and it probably will grow since the time that you'll be on. So like the time that I'm recording, it's only commands that I've put in. You can select ones that impact you, ones that impact mobs, and ones that impact everybody on the server. So we can charge all creepers. And then that's probably going to be something you want to make more expensive. So we can put at like 500 bits or something like that. And we can do publish. Now, if I go and look at my channel again, I refresh, I scroll down, I have charge all creepers. Let's add a couple more commands in quick. Okay, now that I have six commands added, if I add one more, so let's do cuddle huddle all mobs to me, publish. If I go and I look over here, I go to my chat, you'll see I now have a next and a back, and people can page through. I know this GUI is not the most beautiful, but I really think functionality is far more important. So you can see teleport all mobs to me is free right now, and I probably don't want that to be free. So I'm going to go back to the command manager, delete this, hit return, and go to simple commands and to me and make that, you know, 250 bits or whatever. It does not matter what you set for these. It'll just charge that amount of bits per thing. So now that you see here, 250 bits, and it kind of works like that. Okay, now that we have seen how simple commands work, let's build up a command. We're going to do a slash give command. This is pretty simple. We'd normally do slash give at s cobblestone, right? And we would get cobblestone. Well, we don't have at s because remember, this could be running from anybody anywhere. So what we're going to do is give, and we're going to put in a squiggly brace, which is usually above the square brackets, or you can copy it from the description. Char underscore name, so that's character name, and then we'll do cobblestone, right? So now we can do that, and it'll add it to a list of commands. What you can do now is add as many commands as you want. So you can, these will all run in the same game tick, so, and they'll run in the order that you're submitting them. So if you want to do something like this, where we're going to do execute a title char underscore name, and then we're going to do here is some cobble. So now what it'll do is it'll execute gives the cobblestone, and then it'll check the it'll give you the title. So now I do give cobble, so I have to hit submit, publish, test. Here's some cobble. If I don't, now that I've submitted it, I can go to view submitted, and you'll see that it's pending. What I mean by pending is that I, as the owner of this extension, am responsible for some form of the contents that are in my extension. I have to go through and approve the commands for them to be spendable for bits. So you look through here, I submitted all of these commands myself. Individuals can submit the commands, and I will go through and review them when I get a chance to make sure that they are acceptable. You can use them for free in my command manager. So like, right, I give cobbles here, but it's for 0 bits. When you are testing these commands, make sure that you go through and delete the free ones that you have as your pending commands. After I go through and approve it, it'll end up becoming a simple command and it will go through and be categorized in here. However, I categorize it. So me as the extension owner will have to go and categorize things and set them up. Sometimes that might happen quickly. Sometimes it might take a couple of days or a couple of weeks, depending on how busy I am. But the simple commands will be available for bits, and the custom commands will be something that you have to wait for me to approve to make it available for bits. It's available for free immediately, but it to make it available for bits takes some time. So now we've gone through the configuring a server, entering simple commands, entering custom commands, and then managing your commands, viewing your submits. It's just for your own informational purposes. It doesn't have any functionality there. And then the credits are to the people who have licensed out the fonts that I used. So that is basically it. If you like what's going on here, please do subscribe. Please use it. I do take a small percentage. I don't get to control the percentage. I take a percentage of the bits that you do use. So if you do like this and you do use it, it does support me and the channel and what I do. Anyway, well, this is Alex because my skin was broken, but this is Mad Hatter and I'm out. Thanks. Bye.